Ahoy!
As you all know, Glass Animal's new album, Dreamland, was released just a few days prior. Now, I am the world's biggest Glass Animals fan. Self-proclaimed, of course, but it's the truth. Now, today, I'm not gonna react to the album. I was gonna. Let me tell you. My first thought was, obviously, reaction video. But then I thought, oh wait, it's a whole album. That's a lot. That's a lot to react to. That's a lot of time. Also, since I can't actually play the songs, it's sort of pointless because it's like you can't hear what I'm reacting to unless you play it on your end, which could be a good idea. Maybe I could have, I should, that's a good idea actually. I didn't consider that one. But anyways, that's not what happened because I went on a run, a bit of a long run, and I listened to the album twice through. Once with all the songs and then the second time skipping the ones I already knew because I'm not gonna run for 2 hours. It was just an hour and a half. Sorry, I didn't mean to flex on you so hard, but anyways, what I'm gonna do instead is just sort of talk about all my favorite Glass Animals songs. I'm just gonna sort of like talk about Glass Animals. So this is the Idiot's Guide to Glass Animals, essentially. This is the Dummy's Guide. What were those called? Oh, Glass Animals for Dummies. Well, not dummies. This is just Glass Animals for people who don't listen to Glass Animals, or people who do and want a little more in-depth look at their good shit. If you don't know what to listen to, if you're like just approaching Glass Animals and you don't really get it, you're just looking at their top, their popular list. Okay, well, let's just dive right in. Here we go. Wait, no, let me finish my thought. If you're just like looking at the popular list and you're like, oh, I'm not really vibing with these, or I don't really understand, let me help you. Here, take my hand. Take it. Come on. I washed it for 20 seconds. Come on. Okay. Aww. Here, wait, this would be you. Okay, cool. Come with me. Let's go. So, I'm gonna just look right here at their popular. What we got here? Number one, Heat Waves. Heat Waves was a single that was released, what, a month ago? And it is on the album Dreamland. So for it to be their number one most popular song, is that's kind of nuts. Because it's one of their most recent releases. And it's bomb. It is a bomb song. You know what? I think part of the reason it is the most popular one is because they held a little competition for anyone who wanted to make a remix of the song or cover or any sort of version of the song and send it into them. And then they would pick their favorites and they're gonna release one as on their Spotify, like as a produced song. So everyone who participated in that competition, including myself, was just like listening to it on repeat, you know, to like, I don't know, probably, that's my guess. But I also think maybe they marketed it really well, or it just came at a good time, slash it is just a bomb song. Oh, let's play a snippet. Okay, so it is bomb. It is such a good summer jam. And it's got elements of that love shit in it. You know, if you've got a little summer romance going, or you were thinking about someone before or during lockdown, and maybe it's over, or maybe it's like not even. Like, it just kind of always works. You could just insert anyone into that. It's pretty dope. That's a bomb song. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. Unfortunately, I did already play it out. Number two on their popular list is Gooey. Now, Gooey is an absolute classic. Gooey is probably their first song that really popped off. It came from ZABA, their like debut album, and it's like everybody's favorite on that album. It's not my favorite on the album. I love the song, but I don't think it's the best one. Let's just play it. Oh my god, take me back to ZABA. Are you shitting me? Here comes that famous bass. Mama, I think a big part of the reason that song popped off so hard is because it was our first introduction to Dave's silly little lyrics. References to Pooh Bear, peanut butter vibes, like just nobody got it and everybody got it. You know what I mean? Like you're like, what? But you totally get it. But you're like, what? And you know, that song really builds up at the end and it just becomes so overstimulating in the best way. Start playing these over my speaker because I'm just not getting the full effect here. The next song on their top is Tokyo Driftin'. Now Tokyo Driftin' was the first song we heard from them since How to Be a Human Being. That was in I think October of 2019. That song hit me like a Lamborghini. It was such a drastic step away from anything we've heard from them before. Absolutely shocking. Incredible. Mixed reviews. Dave's voice. Probably the most shocking thing. I actually didn't realize it was him singing until after the song had finished. I was crying a lot. I actually have my reaction on video, but it's so embarrassing because I got so emotional that I have it up and it's on private. Maybe one day if I'm feeling really brave, I'll put it up. But today's not that day. So anyways, here's Tokyo Drifting. Oh my god, I should be wearing my shirt. Hold on. That one just gets me going a little too hard. That one's such a good party banging song because it's literally just about like being that version of yourself. You know, the one that's just completely unhinged, unafraid. Just like that version of yourself in your head that is the life of the party. I'm out of breath. I might be able to run 8.5 miles. But Dancing to Glass Animals really takes it out of me. All right, next up, The Other Side of Paradise. Oh! So this is the only, okay, on their top five, this is the only one from How to Be a Human Being, which is nuts. So How to Be a Human Being is their sophomore album. I know that term. But it's their second album, and it's like arguably the best one. The only reason I'm saying that is because I'm literally married to that album. Like, we're in a relationship. And Dreamland is still new, you know? Dreamland is the new bae. And, okay, we'll get to it. We'll get to it. We'll get to my feelings on new bae. But, like, How to Be a Human Being is OG bae. We're already married. It's like, do I turn this into a polygamous marriage? And the answer is probably yes. The Other Side of Paradise. Oh, God. Here we go again. Here we freaking go again. This one's gonna start off really fast, to be honest. Here we go. You're not even ready. Sorry. It needs to be playing on my phone. Sorry.
I was young.
don't even need to tell you why that song is on this list. It was like an amazing, that's just fucking power in your ears. That's just, so let's just move right along. Your Love, parentheses Deja Vu, is number 5 on the popular list on Spotify. Your Love was released after Tokyo Drifting. I wanna say like February, January, February, you know what? I know exactly. So 24 weeks ago, that one was released. Oh my God, is it good? It is so good. Sorry, whew, it just started. Ah! This one's really fun, it's super upbeat. It's got their little quirks, it's got the whoop, bloop. It's got this fun little flute that we've just never heard Glass Animals use before. And then it's just so catchy, and it got that low swing, like, dun, dun, dun. Yeah, it's good, it's a really good song. Okay, so let's just play a snippet of it. I should put on there, I need to put on a different sweater. Shut my eyes, you call, but I just cut the line. I know you'll slide, I know that you won't hold your mind. I'm backside, and can do this just one more time. Gift to me from my great friend in New York. We went to their concert together. I'm obsessed with the sweater and I spilled some sort of fucking shit all over. Can you see? Do you see that? It's like oil or something. I washed it. I can't get the shit out. It's absolutely ruined. But it's okay. My guys, I'm gonna still wear it. So anyways, if I kept going down this popular list, we'd still, I mean, I'm gonna have to play pretty much all these songs anyways. But that's what I'm gonna talk about on their popular list because, okay, because that's the top 5. That's what people would generally just listen to. The question everybody's asking, is that representative of Glass Animals music? I don't know. Like, yeah, it is, but they're not my favorite. Those are not my favorite songs. So we're just gonna go from each album. What I'm gonna do is actually not go into anything before ZABA, like Leaflings. I could go into some of those songs. I used to go pretty hard to Golden Antlers, not gonna lie, but I just don't think that that music necessarily holds up in today's, especially when you think of Glass Animals, like, it's just not the same. So I'm just gonna go straight into the ZABA album and skip all the other stuff. ZABA! ZABA Deluxe, baby, 2014! This band graced us with this masterpiece. So, this is beautiful, glorious album, and the record itself is actually like tie-dye's dope as hell. Actually, I have two of them. I wanted to keep one in its casing forever, and the other one I use. Isn't that terrible? I'm actually a hoarder. That's, I hate myself for doing that, but I did it. So anyways, okay, if you really want the full experience of ZABA, you have to listen to it from beginning to end, like with your eyes closed in one of those sensory deprivation tank. And just get lost in the sauce. Because essentially what this album does is take you through this like jungle. Each stop is this like weird, bizarre world. And then halfway through, there's this like split and it's so, it builds, and then it just kind of comes back down. Okay, so anyways, Black Mambo is one of the most popular. Pools, Gooey, and Hazy. Those are the four most popular. My favorites are, I love Pools. I'd have to say Pools. Intrux, Toes, JDNT, and Cocoa Hooves. I could even throw Weird on there, but I won't. I'm gonna say JDNT, I think is actually my favorite one. I just think it's really underappreciated and it slaps so hard. Cocoa Hooves, like, actually takes me to another fucking planet, and I'm not even kidding about that. Hazy is a really fun, upbeat one. Live. They played that one live. They played a lot more upbeat. What do I do? Okay, I'll start with Pools. We'll just go in order, right? Okay, so Pools is the first one out of all of those. You need to listen to Black Mambo, but I'm not gonna play it. You need to listen to it, but I'm not gonna play it. Oh yeah, so if you hear that in the beginning, those little jungly noises, that's because each song ends on a sort of atmospheric sound, and then the next song just picks right up off of that. You don't even notice when they change. So like, I'll play the end of Black Mambo, and you... You tell me when you think pool starts. I know exactly where it is. By the way, it's already started and you just didn't realize it. That's how genius it is. But now we're just gonna keep going right into it. Super fun. Ain't no denying that. Okay, next one. In trucks. Now, I said in trucks was one of my favorites because it is. And here's why. In trucks, it doesn't have any words. Actually, it does. But they're not legible and you don't really want to sing to them. Okay, you know what? I can't actually, like, explain it. Let's just listen. That's bullying right there. I have to deal with that in my own home.
Why did you stop being weird?
Thank you. This is a problem with America. That one is the lyrics are gone inside of the wild Zaba Jabba, all the mad and the sad gonna have at ya. Sour plants, hungry fangs, Jabba Zaba, tangle mass in the vast Zaba Jabba, because it's taken old book. So there's like a book called Zaba Jabba, and that's what it's inspired by. And that's where like the title of this whole album comes from. So that's just an important, that's a pinnacle part of this album. Next one I'm gonna show you, toes. Love me some toes. Catch them playing that song again live because they just have way too many songs now. But I gotta see it. Sorry, that's so rude. I do Coco Hooves and JD&T, and then we'll move on from ZABA. Coco Hooves. When you just want to chill, that song will take you there. Here we go. I often listen to this when I'm driving at night, but sometimes. That's dangerous, you know, because it might just put you to sleep. Skip a little to the drop. I'm gonna skip forward in this song to like the big drop. It's like rolls of just like bass. Oh, here it comes. Here we go. Right? Was I wrong? No. Okay, JD&T. This one's my favorite. Here we go. ZABA, I am just taking up so much time. The rest of them are absolute bangers too. Walla Walla and Weird, I should have talked about, but I didn't. Okay, we gotta move on to How to Be a Human Being, because this album is one of the most genius things in the whole world. Like, I'm not qualified to be a music critic. Like, obviously, I'm not Anthony Fantano or whatever. I can't, like, really speak with a whole lot of authority on this. But I think it's one of the greatest art masterpieces in the whole world. This album, Dave doesn't really talk about too much, because he likes for us to interpret stuff. With this album, with Dreamland, he's been open about everything. He's like, ask me any questions you have, I'm gonna tell you everything. I'm literally sweating so much. How to Be a Human Being, each song is about a different character. When they were touring ZABA, Dave went around and interviewed a whole bunch of people on tour and created these characters inspired by real people and also, you know, whatever. These are their stories and they, every single aspect of it, lyrics, sounds, overall vibe and feel is this character. So I think it's super fun. Life Itself is the opener of it. It is so good. It is just such a good vibes, upbeat, like boom, boom, boom. Youth is really great too. It's a little more like, it's a little more toned down. Season 2, episode 3 is the juiciest bit of music. It is, sounds like a video game. If you've not heard it, then you're in for an absolute treat and I wish I was you. Pork Soda is like the epitome of glass animals. It's the pineapples in my head. It's the pineapple song. It's everybody brings pineapples to their thing and Dave throws a pineapple. It's cause the lyrics are pineapples are in my head. We all just clung onto that line. Mama's Gun is my favorite glass animal song in the whole world. There, I said it. Now you know. It's just the one that resonates with me. It just, in my soul. It just like rings throughout my soul. And I just like look up at the, oh, I have a relationship with that song. The next one is Cane Sugar. This one is so good. Just like season 2, episode 3, it's probably something you've not really heard anything quite like. Pre-made sandwiches is spoken word. It's really fast, it's pitched down really low. And they used to open the concerts with it. It's really fun. The Other Side of Paradise, we already heard. Take a Slice is about a prostitute, and it's just a swinging song. I fuck with it. Poplar Street is really good. It's a really good song, and Agnes makes me cry. Which do I show you? You have to listen to Life Itself and Pork Soda. You have to. Those are like the epitome of Glass Animal songs. They just are. So for that reason, I think I might not include them in this video because you just have to go listen to them. But maybe you won't. Okay, fine. I'm gonna play Life Itself. I'm gonna do it. Who doesn't love those drums? Actually, that's happening right here. Lost in boxes outside Tesco. That Lost in Boxes Outside Tesco, I've listened to that song for like 2 or 3 years, and then I went to London and found out what Tesco was. So that's funny. I had just no idea what he was saying. Tesco's like a Walmart kind of. It's a store. Okay, so that's Life Itself. Obviously a banger. And then I'm just gonna play. Okay, season 2, episode 3. You have to hear it, because you're not gonna believe me. Here we go. The most famous lyric from this song is, right, like you get it. You're gonna listen to that again. I know you are. Pork Soda. Let's just get into it. For the course. I'm We're gonna have to move on, but I mean, who isn't having the best time of their lives? Mama's Gun is next. Mama's Gun is my favorite one. It's my favorite one. And I'm not gonna play it. I'm not gonna play it. It's my favorite one, and I can't play it for you. Cane Sugar. Is gonna be the most like classic sort of classic rocky sounding type of deal. It's guitar. You should listen to it, but I don't have time because we are moving on to Dreamland. Now, like I said, I am already married to how to be a human being. Do I have room in my life for a second album? Husband. Perhaps, because this album is really proving itself to be worthy and interesting and everything I need. It's just got all those qualities that I look for in an album. It excites me. It keeps me guessing. Keeps me on my toes. It's got some absolute bangers, and it's got some that just chill you right out, that put you right into your feelings. And I love being in my feelings. And as a Pisces, I exist in Dreamland anyways. So it's like, was this made for me? I think so. Dreamland opens with the song Dreamland. That one was released, when was that? That was the beginning of quarantine, kind of. So what, like March? March, April? It's such a nice song. God, I love it. On a foggy morning, Dreamland. Let's hear it. This is how the album opens. Just a dream of a song. Now, Tangerine is so fun. When I saw them in New York, they played this song for us, and I could not wait to hear it. It's just such a fun summer bop. Like, let's just play a little bit of it. It's so fruity. Like, what? Oh, it's just like so up here. That like thick harmony. Voice. Right? Like, that's so, it just sounds like a tangerine. So fun. So fruity and fun. Fresh. I just want to be on a fucking island, but I'm stuck in quarantine. Hot Sugar. This one's dope. This is such a vibe. It's such a vibey song. Ooh. I feel like I'm in a spaceship. But then there's some like low-key Marvin Gaye vibes. That song, actually, I could have written about Dave. I don't want to be around you, I just want to be like you. Like, I love him. I think he's the coolest person ever. But then, like, if I actually got up in person with him, like, it'd just be so... I'd be like, ah. I mean, I have. I have met Dave and had a conversation with Dave, and I was so nervous. I think I was talking a million miles per hour, kind of like I am right now. Whew. Okay, wait. I just really want to be like him, is what it is, what it comes down to. So anyways, that one's great. Okay, the next song is Space Ghost Coast to Coast. That, I'm pretty sure it's like a TV show or something. I will literally never get tired of this song. Like, this is the coolest song ever. It sounds kind of like Mama's Gun in the melody that he's singing. It also kind of sounds like Cane Sugar in just the fact that it's a sort of a beat. Okay, let's just listen to it. How about that? Here we go. Ooh. Oh my God. Tired of that song. Okay. Now, here's what makes this video different from the rest of the Glass Animals videos you might ever happen upon. This is what makes this video so much more informative, because if you like that shit, then you're gonna like something else. Dave Bailey produced some music for an artist called Susie Wu, who is dope. She's awesome. And this song came out 2019 while I was in London. This song sounds really similar to that. So if you like that shit, you're gonna like this. It's the same shit. Here comes that famous bass. We got a little more of that militaristic sort of sound coming up right here. Susie Wu, check her out. Dope artist. But anyways, back to Glass Animals. Just thought I'd throw that in there for you. Melon and the Coconut, that is just the funniest song I've literally ever heard in my life. I'm just gonna play you my favorite line from it. I can't even put them on. That's so funny. Also, my camera is gonna die, so I'm gonna wrap this baby right up. Waterfalls coming out your mouth, incredible. But my favorite song on this album is It's Also Incredibly Loud, like Mama's Gun. It's my Mama's Gun of this album, and I think it just might be my favorite Glass Animals song of all time. Yes, I think I'm moving on. Not moving on. I mean, I still love Mama's Gun and How to Be a Human Being, but I think it's also incredibly loud. It's just resonating with me more right now, you know what I mean? Let's not even get into it. I'm not even gonna play it, okay? I'm not gonna play it. You have to go listen to it. And then Helium, the way he wraps up this album, this song. Listen to the end, listen to the end. We gotta take it back. Ends the album like he starts it. Incredible wrap up. And yeah. My camera is scaring the shit out of me. Like, stop flashing. So I'm just gonna say that album is crazy more personal to Dave than the other two. First one's like this adventure through the jungle. The second one is like all these other characters. And then this one is like him. I don't know. It just feels so personal. And it's also high. This is probably a little confusing, but my camera died right as I was about to finish that sentence. So, what was I saying?
It just feels so personal.
Right. Yeah, this out the Dreamland album, I mean, and so many more of them are about love. Like, you really can't get away from it. And if you read the descriptions on Spotify of what the songs are about, they're about, like, relationships and things, not necessarily between, like, two lovers. I mean, Melon and the Coconut is about literally a relationship between Melon and a coconut. And, like, there's some really personal stuff in this album, which is, you know, it's just not something that we've heard from them before, which is really cool. Yeah, make sure you listen to all the songs that I didn't play, because those are super important, I'm telling you. You gotta get the full, you gotta hear them. Oh my god. I have to show you guys something. Okay, remember how I was like, oh my god, Yee Toys reached out and they're making these dope The Last of Us 2 phone cases? Well, somebody DM'd me. Thank you, Savior. I forget who I can't quite remember who did it, but they told me that they made a Dina phone case. And so I clicked my own link and friggin' bought that. Like, what? Am I even making, can I make the face? Can I? Do I even look like that? I don't know. But, what? That's too much. Can you imagine, like, me just, like, being on the phone and then, like, turning and my own face is on my phone. Like, that's ridiculous. I'm excited to be that extra. Like, right? Let's just mess it up in the world. Let's just mess it all up. I hate this country. Anyway, that has nothing to do with glass animals. But anyways, link in my description if you wanna pick up one of these. That's nutty. I also want to iterate. I've said this at every single point, but I think that it keeps getting forgotten, the fact that I'm literally just the face. Like, I did not create this character. This is Shannon Woodward's art, her masterpiece, her character, her acting, her artistry. Praise her. I have not played it yet, but I'm sure, based on the reviews, based on what I'm hearing, that she did an amazing job. So, don't get it twisted. I'm literally so unimportant. It is just my face. But it is my face. So that's kind of personal. Yeah, okay, anyways, that's all I had to say. I hope you enjoyed the video. Wow, damn, it's really long. If you made it this far, you are absolutely so dope. If you made it this far, comment down below, your fucking coconut can't even put them on. Okay, I love you guys. And I'll see you in the next vid. Okay, bye.